Good morning, Hank. It's Tuesday. So one of my favorite YouTubers, CGP Grey, Lincoln the Doobly-Doo, recently did a video debunking 10 popular misconceptions. This inspired me to want to debunk more misconceptions. For instance, number one, the Quran says all martyrs get 72 virgins in heaven. Yeah, the Quran doesn't say that. That tradition comes from a hadith, which are collections of sayings of the Prophet Muhammad. And that particular hadith is really poorly sourced. It's like, I heard from a guy who talked to a guy, and his cousin was all like that the Prophet had said like 72 virgins or something. Furthermore, Hank, there are some people who argue that the word virgins is being mistranslated here and that the actual translation is like white grapes. Misconception number two, 0.999 repeating is less than one. In fact, 0.999 repeating is equal to one, which you know because 0.333 repeating is equal to 1/3, and 1/3 plus 1/3 plus 1/3 is one. Misconception number three, ostriches bury their head in the sand to hide from predators. Incorrect. They bury their heads in the sand because they have to dig nests and they don't have hands with which to dig. Misconception number four, sharks don't get cancer, so you should eat shark to keep yourself from getting cancer. In fact, sharks do get cancer, although we don't know how often because everyone is always killing them. Misconception number five, there is an edge to the universe. So Hank, during the last week of our tour, you became obsessed with the fact that there is no edge to the universe. But instead of saying it like that, you just kept saying, dude, no edge. And you kept accusing me of being inadequately fascinated about the lack of edginess in the universe, when in fact it was your portrayal of this fact that was so annoying to me, because you'd just be like eating a sandwich or something and you'd turn to me and be like, hey John, there is no edge. But anyway, yes, apparently there is no edge to the universe. I still don't understand how that works, but I'm sure that you will explain it to me. Misconception number six, Albert Einstein failed mathematics. No, he didn't. Albert Einstein was really, really good at mathematics. In fact, to quote him, before I was 15, I had mastered differential calculus. Misconception number seven, Al Gore claimed to have invented the internet. No, he didn't. He claimed to have taken the initiative in creating the internet, which is also an exaggeration, but just not the same exaggeration that people accuse him of. Misconception number eight, late in the winter of your 17th year, you are 17. No, late in the winter of your first year, you are still zero. Late in the winter of your second year, you are one. And late in the winter of your 17th year, you are 16. Misconception number nine, humans have five senses. Wrong. Humans have way more than five senses. The five senses were identified by Aristotle, and here's a little rule of thumb. Aristotle, while he is very famous and everything, is almost always wrong. In addition to the five senses we all know, you can also sense relative temperature, which is called thermoception. You can sense body and limb position. And you can sense balance, which is called equilibrioception. You can also sense the need to go deeper, which is called inception. Sorry. I apologize. I apologize to my whole family for that. Misconception number 10, George Washington had wooden dentures. No, alas, his dentures were far more disturbing than that. They were made of gold, lead, hippopotamus, ivory, dead people teeth, and donkey teeth. Link in the doobly-doo to the original video, also to Michael Aranda's brilliant video of Hank saying no edge over and over again. Also, have you seen our new show Crash Course? We're teaching you about stuff. Here's a preview. The test will measure whether you are an informed, engaged, and productive citizen of the world, and it will take place in schools and bars and hospitals and dorm rooms and in places of worship. The test will judge your ability to think about things other than celebrity marriages, whether you'll be easily persuaded by empty political rhetoric, and whether you'll be able to place your life and your community in a broader context. The test will last your entire life, and it will be comprised of the millions of decisions that, when taken together, make your life yours. And everything, everything will be on it. Hank, I hope you're feeling better. Don't forget to be awesome. I will see you on Friday.